Struggling with blood sugar levels, ready to shed those extra pounds effortlessly? Look no further. Sugar Defender, the number one rated blood sugar formula, is here to transform your health and help you achieve your wellness goals. Click the link in the video description to get started with Sugar Defender today.
Somewhere in a storage room at Edinburgh's Harriet Watt University, a stone monument weighing nearly a ton gathers dust. It is inscribed with these words from First Minister Alex Salmond: "The rocks will melt with the sun before I allow tuition fees to be imposed on Scotland's students." When it was unveiled in an outdoor area of the campus on his penultimate day in office almost a decade ago, it certainly had the appearance of permanence. It remained in place less than 6 years. By the time it was removed, Mr. Salmond was no longer a member of the party he had dominated for a generation. Rocks would have melted with the sun, many would have imagined, before he left the SNP. He had just faced a criminal trial on a string of sexual assault charges brought by senior women in his former party and, despite his acquittal on every count, was left a discredited and diminished figure. Few saw that coming in November 2014 when he unveiled the so-called Salmond Stone and declared the abolition of tuition fees the single biggest achievement of his government. Rather easier to predict back then was the unraveling of this hubris tick policy somewhat earlier in planet Earth's timeline than the moment when the sun expands and sets it aflame. Even in 2014, the realization was dawning that, far from increasing access to university for Scotland's prospective students, free tuition was freezing many of them out. 10 years on, the challenges facing high-achieving Scots wishing to study at one of their own nation's universities are yet more acute. And the challenge free tuition fees, present to some of Scotland's seats of higher learning, has become an existential one. One leading economist stated days ago that universities face a significant risk of closure as long as free degrees are offered to Scottish students. Dr. Gavin Conlon, a partner with consultancy firm London Economics, noted that more than half the country's 19 universities are in deficit and some don't have any sort of reserves whatsoever to cover what is essentially their overdraft. The umbrella body Universities Scotland also laid it on the line to Holyrood this week. It told the Education Committee that Scottish Government funding cuts and plummeting applications from international students had combined to put at least 10 of our 19 universities into the red. This is forcing institutions into inescapably hard choices, it said. And it is clear many of them are already making those choices. In December 2023, the University of Aberdeen scrapped its single honours languages degrees to address a £1.5 million deficit accrued by the department in a single year. It later transpired the university's troubles went much deeper than that. In its annual report published last month, the 529-year-old institution revealed there had been significant doubt at one point in the year over its ability to continue at all as a going concern. Elsewhere in the city, Robert Gordon University is running a voluntary severance scheme as it seeks to plug an £18 million hole in its budget. The University of the Highlands and Islands is having to restructure its entire operation to save £4 million. While all this goes on, the SNP's self-congratulatory tone on tuition fees remains unaltered. And, among its opponents, no one yet dares to say what many are thinking: that the introduction of some form of charge for Scottish students is looking inevitable. All of which begs a question for every party in the Parliament: when will politicians wake up to their own inescapably hard choices over tuition fees? Hiding their heads in the sand will no longer cut it, argues Alison Payne, research director at the think tank Reform Scotland, who warns that failure to intervene now will result in far bigger pains and costlier fixes ahead. More and more top academics are urging a rethink on tuition fees. This week it was Sir Paul Grice, Vice Chancellor of Queen Margaret University in Edinburgh, who said a more sustainable, politically acceptable funding model must be found. He added, "It's not really free, somebody has to pay for it." Stepping down from his post as head of Universities Scotland a few weeks ago, Alastair Sim said Scotland needed to have a serious conversation about the best way to support universities, or risk their severe degradation. Last year, Professor Sir Peter Matheson, principal of Edinburgh University, suggested